Hi, my name is Jason from Sow the Land, and this is our shop inside Atomic Furnishing and Design in Asheville, North Carolina. We make and sell from our small homestead, and we also have our own website where we sell the things that we make on our homestead. And today I'm bringing in some more product. I try to update our shop here as much as possible, and we have cutting boards that I'm bringing in today. To pull out our chicken tractor. Been sitting here for, I think it's been 7 months since last we used it. It's a bit overgrown. Probably gonna have to make another feeder because now we have two of these chicken tractors for our meat birds. I'm gonna move this other chicken tractor. I didn't think we're gonna need that 2x4 with the meat chickens in here. We never have a roosting bar on here for the meat birds, but I'm gonna leave this one in here because I'm starting off our baby chicks on grass. So this is gonna be also their brooder, but it's gonna be on grass outside. And I'm still gonna put a heat lamp on them, and I'm gonna use that bar to hopefully put the heat lamp on it. But I started the chickens on grass last year for the first time, and it went really well. And I think it's important that we have chickens on grass like as soon as possible.
Well, we've been working really hard, and so this morning we did a little more planting. We just have row 10, 11, and then 13, but you know what, 13 has that tarp over it, so we need to take off the tarp and then check it to see if those plants are dead. We're expecting to get a cattle panel for our trellis, for our yard long beans, and for our cucumbers.
Another thing I need to do before them chickens come is I need to build another feeder for them. And I'm gonna use this 4-inch pipe. We already have one of these feeders, and we just need another one for our other chicken tractor. And I need to split this in half, and the quickest way I know to do that is table saw. Now that was pretty easy. You just have to watch your fingers. And now I need a stopper piece at the ends. This is actually cedar wood, and so I need to cut it out to match this shape. And the quickest way for me to do that is my bandsaw. I know not everybody has a bandsaw, but you can probably get away with using maybe a jigsaw. So all in all, this chicken feeder trough costs me about $5 to make. Now I added this hook on here, that's for the water. So I still have to make the chicken water, but at least the trough's done. These are the tomatoes that we started from seed. And so we already planted them And I think it's important to try to stay on top of these. It is difficult, but you know, we do our best.
What you got there?
And I made up a map. No, that's just a recipe. This is a map. This is a map.
What is that map? What's the map called? What is it?
I don't know what it's called. It's called Master of the Planners.
You planted flowers?
Yeah, I just planted some cut flowers. Right when their stone is, that's where the cut flowers are. So it's gonna be very pale. I call it Penelope's Flower Farm Patch.
I just had a loud thunder. I think, as it gets closer to summer, we get some loud thunders here. Like, it'll be clear and like with a few clouds, and then all of a sudden like a big loud thunder, and then a short time later it'll usually just pour. Even if it's for like 5 minutes, it's crazy how much it rains, how often it rains.
We have a lot of beets mixed in here. You don't need to push them down too far because they're such tiny little seeds.
So we planted, these are beans?
Yes, those are purple yard long beans.